Zombie Apocalypse. So hello viewers, today we are going to start the topic of pathophysiology of peptic ulcer. So please stay with me. Dear students, we are going to start our topic on peptic ulcer, mainly pathophysiology of peptic ulcer. Okay, so what is peptic ulcer? Degeneration and necrosis of GI mucosa due to acid pepsin secretion. So it is the degeneration and necrosis of the gastric mucosal layer, mainly inside the stomach or duodenum, due to acid and pepsic secretion. Acid means HCl, hydrochloric acid, which is very important for our digestion as well as for the destruction of the microbes entering into our GI tract. Okay, and pepsin is a proteolytic enzyme which is also very essential for the digestion of our foodstuffs. Okay, so most common part of the peptic ulcer region is first part of duodenum followed by stomach. Okay, so in this case there are two terms are there, mainly aggressive factors and protective factors. What are the aggressive factors? Aggressive factors are those factors which are mainly pepsin, hydrochloric acid, and also different type of chemical irritants like smoking, alcohol, etc., etc. And protective factors are bicarbonate ions, also the mucus or the mucus secretion. They are also the protective factors. So aggressive factors are try to destroy the mucosal layers and protective factors try to protect the mucosal layers. So when there is a imbalance between those two factors, that will lead to the peptic ulcer. Okay, so peptic ulcer mainly means a degeneration of the gastric mucosal layer due to acid and pepsin secretion. Okay, so next, what are the classification? What are the classification of peptic ulcer? Okay, mainly peptic ulcer is divided into two parts. First part is acute or stress peptic ulcer. Second part is chronic peptic ulcer. Okay, so what is acute or stress peptic ulcer? It means when the ulcer remains in a particular part, mainly in the stomach. In case of duodenum, this ulcer is not happened or happened in a very few cases. Okay, so in case of stomach, this ulcer is present in a few parts. Okay, and acute means this ulcer will sustain for a shorter duration of time, and chronic means this ulcer will sustain for a longer duration of time. There, this is the main difference between the acute and chronic ulcer. Okay, so what are the etiology? Etiology means what are the causes of that acute or stress peptic ulcer. Mainly the causes are psychological stress, physiological stress, shock, severe trauma, septicemia, extensive burns, intracranial lesions. Okay, so these are the main causes, means psychological stress. If a person is suffering from some psychological stress, so he or she must be suffering from that particular ulcer. Okay, because stress secretes different type of chemicals or molecules which are directly proportional or indirectly proportional to the HCl secretion. Okay, so that may create also ulcer. Okay, so in case of physiological stress, mainly shock, severe trauma, septicemia means any type of infection which occurs inside the blood, they will cause also the ulcer. Extensive burns, intracranial lesions means any type of damage inside the cranial cavity or means inside the brain cell. Okay, so this type of damage will also create the peptic ulcer, means acute peptic ulcer. In case of NSAID, means non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, which drugs are mainly responsible for degeneration of pain sensation or any type of decrement of pyrexia or any type of decrement of inflammation. This type of drugs are mainly NSAIDs. So they are also responsible for the generation of peptic ulcer because they are used to inhibit the prostaglandin synthesis. Okay, so this prostaglandin synthesis also have a role in the secretion of mucus, okay, which are the protective factors. So due to the less generation of prostaglandins also leads to the degeneration of mucus secretion, which leads to ultimately the peptic ulcer. Okay, so local irritants, different type of local irritants, mainly smoking, alcohol, they are also used to represent the peptic ulcer. Okay, next, pathogenesis. What are the pathogenesis? Pathogenesis means how the disease progresses in our body. Okay, so pathogenesis, casting stress ulcer means any type of damage due to any type of surgery in the brain tumors, any type of surgery in the brains that will be smaller or bigger, any type of lesion, any type of impact in the brain cell, that will also cause the ulcer. They are called the Cushing stress ulcer. Hypoxic injury. Hypoxic injury means when the oxygen deficiency is occurred inside our cells, they are called hypoxia. It is also called as ischemia due to deficiency of oxygen in the cell. So they are also causing the hypoxic injury, or that will lead to the peptic ulcer. Okay, depletion of mucus barrier. Okay, they are also responsible for the peptic ulcer because depletion of mucus barrier causes the acid or ACL to come into the contact of the particular mucus membrane. So they are also causing the peptic ulcer. Okay, so these are the main pathogenesis of acute or stress peptic ulcer. So now we have to come into the chronic peptic ulcer. What are the etiologies? H. pylori infection. H. pylori means a bacteria which is also called as Helicobacter pylori. Helicobacter pylori. They are also responsible for the creation of ulcer because these type of bacteria are responsible for the high urease activity inside our stomach. And due to that high urease activity, many proportion of nitrogen is originated inside our stomach. And this origination of nitrogen remains the stomach's environment basic. But we know that naturally stomach is acidic, means its environment is acidic. So when the environment of the stomach is basic due to that H. pylori, the stomach tends to create an acidic environment inside it, and it secretes more and more HCl. So this more and more secretion of HCl, which also causes us peptic ulcer. So H. pylori infection is also important cause of chronic peptic ulcer. And this chronic peptic ulcer is divided into two parts, mainly duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. Means the ulcer which is represent the duodenum, or which has happened inside the duodenum, that is called duodenal ulcer. And the ulcer which remains inside the stomach, that is also called as gastric ulcer. Okay. NSAID. I have also discussed it earlier that NSAIDs are also responsible for the formation of ulcer. The reason is same, due to the depletion of prostaglandin concentration, which causes the depletion of mucus secretion. Acid pepsin secretion, they are also important. Gastritis. Gastritis means due to the secretion of gastrin. Gastrin is a hormone which will also increase the secretion of HCl. That will cause peptic ulcer. In case of other local irritants, means smoking, alcoholism, they are also responsible for the creation of peptic ulcer. Dietary factors, means in case of gastric ulcer, this ulcer is mainly represent the lower economic level, or where the dietary foods are not supplied well. In case of duodenal ulcer, they are represent the higher economic level, where the foodstuffs are enough, but there will lot of stress and anxiety due to the financial and also due to the job and professional stresses. Okay. Physiological factors, I've also discussed it. Genetic factors, you have to know that in case of O positive blood group, these persons are mainly prone to the susceptible of peptic ulcer. Okay, so these type of persons are mainly suffering from peptic ulcer, the O positive blood group, and also the monozygotic twins, they are also susceptible to the peptic ulcers. Hormonal means gastric, or the gastrin hormone, it is secreted when the HCl secretion is increased. Okay, so when the gastrin secretion is increased, the HCl secretion is also increased. So it also causes the peptic ulcer. So these are the etiological factors of chronic peptic ulcer. Chronic means the ulcer which remains in a greater or long duration of time. We have already discussed about the acute and or stress peptic ulcer. Now we have discussed about chronic peptic ulcer. We have already discussed the etiology of chronic peptic ulcer, but now this is the turn of pathogenesis of chronic peptic ulcer. So chronic peptic ulcer is subdivided into two parts, duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. So the pathogenesis of duodenal ulcers are rapid gastric entanglement. Means when your gastric or stomach content are emptying in a rapid basis or emptying very quickly, then the total gastric content remains stuck into the duodenum. So they are causing the duodenal ulcer. High acid pepsin secretion. This is a normal cause of peptic ulcer. HCl secretion at night. Means when the HCl secretion is increased at night, it will causes the duodenal ulcer. Mainly in case of any person who are belonging from any higher designation or higher post, having so much stress or anxiety in his or her life, they are mainly suffering from this type of duodenal ulcer. Okay. Different enzymatic destruction means in our gastrointestinal tract there are different type of enzymes are secreted, just like catalase, protease, urease, also phospholipase, they are also a destructive activity inside the stomach and duodenum. Okay, so the pathogenesis of gastric ulcer, they are mainly the ingested food, means when the food is ingested into the stomach, then the acid secretion is increased, and that will represents the peptic ulcer. Bile reflux means when the bile reflux is increased, means bile pigments like bilirubin, bilirubin, etc. are increased, they will cause also ulcer. Gastritis means when gastrin secretion is increased, they will cause also the gastric ulcer. H. pylori, I have discussed it earlier that in case of H. pylori infection, the UDS activity is increased, that causes excess secretion of nitrogen, that will cause also a imbalance between the acidic and basic environment of the stomach, that will cause also the ulcer. Okay, so these are the pathogenesis of duodenal and gastric ulcer. Okay, so you have to take it in your mind that in case of rich people who are belonging from a higher economic level of the society, they are mainly belonging or mainly suffering from the duodenal ulcer. Or the people who are belonging from a lower economic level, means mainly workers, mainly wage workers, they are mainly suffering from that gastric ulcer. So there is a economic or social basis of that particular ulcer, duodenal and gastric ulcer. Okay. So next, the complications, they are very dangerous. In case of ulcer, there are different type of complications that persist. So they are very dangerous for that particular ulcerative disorder. Okay. So what are the complications? Mainly the first complication is obstruction. Means it is also called as stenosis. Okay, when the ulcer is happened and it is cured by the self immunity, then this cured part of that ulcer will remain a scar, or it remains a scar in that portion. This scar portion, or the scar's portion, becomes shrunken after a long duration of time. So this shrunken scar portion is called as stenosis. And this type of stenosis may also occur in pyloric part. This is called as pyloric stenosis. And when it occurs in the duodenal part, it is called as duodenal stenosis. Okay. So this type of stenosis may occur in case of obstruction. In case of hemorrhage, hemorrhage means bleeding, internal bleeding. In case of peptic ulcer, there must be an internal bleeding in some cases. Because when the ulcer perforates a long part of the body, then it will also perforate different type of blood capillaries or blood vessels. Or mainly in case of hepatoduodenal artery, in case of stomach, or in case of different type of arteries which are surrounding the stomach and duodenum, they are also perforated sometimes, and this perforation causes bleeding by the stools or bleeding by vomiting. These type of problems are called hemorrhage. Perforations means when the stomach or duodenum suffers from a long time ulcer or chronic ulcer, it will perforate sometimes, or the stomach or duodenal layer will be perforates, and the stomach content or duodenal content will be escaped out from the stomach or duodenum into the peritoneal cavity. So this problem is called as perforation, and this will also cause as peritonitis, means inflammation of the peritoneal cavity. So first obstruction, then hemorrhage, then perforation. And the last one is malignant transformation, means when the ulcer is untreated, ulcer remains untreated and it will get severe to severe day by day, then it will also cause sometimes malignancy, means cancer. Okay, so this is called as malignant transformation. So these are the complications of peptic ulcer. They are very important. Okay. So after the clinical features, what are the clinical features? If a person is suffering from any type of ulcer, so what will be the clinical features of him or her? So first, age. Age means you have to stuck it in your mind that in case of duodenal ulcer, the ulcer will be in the fifth decade of your age, means 50 years of age. In case of gastric ulcer, it will be sixth decade of your age, means 60 years of age. The starting period of this type of ulcers are this, means 50 and 60. Okay. In case of pupil at risk, who the pupil at, mainly basically at that risk, mainly in case of duodenal ulcer, the higher economic level pupils are at risk, because they are getting so much anxiety, so much stress, so much tensions, so they are suffering from duodenal ulcer. And in case of lower economic level pupil, mainly the wage workers, mainly the farmers, they are mainly suffering from that gastric ulcer. Okay, so periodicity. What is the periodicity? Means I have already told that fifth and sixth decade of your age is mainly the periodicity of that particular ulcer. But it is also important that nowadays this type of disorders remains no age barrier, or means any pupil of any age can be suffering from that particular disorder. Okay. Pain. Pain means in case of duodenal ulcer, after taking the food, the pain remains stopped. But in case of gastric ulcers, when you take the food, then the pain is started. So this is the main difference. Vomiting. In case of gastric ulcer, there must be some vomiting occurred. Okay. But in case of a duodenal ulcer, there is no chance of vomiting yet. Hematemesis and melena. These are the two important terms. Hematemesis means when the stomach content with blood is vomited out from your body is called hematemesis. And melena means when you have the teri and also the bloody stools, this problem is called as melena. These are also the clinical features of different type of ulcers. Appetite. So in case of duodenal ulcer, the appetite is increased. But in case of gastric ulcer, the appetite is increased because the person is suffering from a panic that when he or she take the food, the pain will be increased. Okay, so appetite is that, diet. In case of gastric ulcer, there will be some restrictions of diet, mainly egg, milk products are not to be taken. But in case of dietary or duodenal ulcer, there will be no restrictions of the diet. But the patient must be have a good and balanced diet in those cases. Deep tenderness means there are some muscle tenderness in case of peptic and duodenal ulcer. Okay, so these are all about the complications of the peptic ulcer. Okay, so you have to understand that ulcers are of two types, means acute ulcer and chronic ulcer, and the chronic ulcer is of two types, means duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. Okay, so this is a part of stomach and it will be divided into some different parts like cardia, fundus, body, pylorus. You know that already in your physiology classes. But in case of that particular stoma, the different parts are different, differently responsible for different type of enzyme or hormone secretion. Okay, so in case of cardia, there are fabular cells, they are secreting mucus, water and glycoproteins. In case of pylorus, there are G cells, they are secreting gastrin. In case of fundus and body, there are parietal cells, they are secreting ACL, and in case of chief cells, they are secreting pepsinogen. And in case of duodenum, they are secreting the bicarbonate ions by the Brunner glands. Okay, so it will be a good part, or this type of diagram will be very important for your study, for memorizing all the things. Because if you know that what are the enzymes or what are the hormones are secreting from which part, then you will also understand that what are the functions or reactions these hormones are going to do. Okay, so this is all about peptic ulcer. Thank you. And also you should go to the description box of that video for a study material that I have given to you. So thank you, viewers. Please like, subscribe, share and comment my channel, and see you at next time. Thank you.